To understand what Neuralink and its technology might actually achieve one day, we should start by asking ourselves, why in the name of Teslas does Elon Musk want to put a brain chip into our heads? It's no secret that artificial intelligence is something that worries Elon Musk a lot. This is because there will come a point eventually when artificial intelligence will surpass humanity, becoming better and more intelligent than we ever will be. Elon Musk has stated in an interview with the New York Times that he believes this breaking point will happen as early as 2025. And I know that this may sound like the plotline of a second-rate science fiction film to you, but bear in mind that the last time that a human being was able to be a computer in a game of chess was back in 2005, 17 years ago. In fact, just a few weeks ago, a robot performed successful intestinal surgery on a pig without any human guidance whatsoever. In other words, the robot used AI to act, predict, and react to any complications during the surgery as they happened in real time. What's more is that according to the scientist at Johns Hopkins, the robot was significantly better than human surgeons at performing tricky and sensitive maneuvers. My condolences to all surgeons everywhere. I guess what I'm trying to say is, what are the odds of any of us keeping our jobs and by extension our livelihoods and independence from governments and corporations if there is a robot out there that can do our jobs better and more cheaply? But Elon Musk still thinks that we have a little bit of hope, so long as we put a microchip into our heads and combine our unique capabilities as humans with those of AI. If you can't beat them, you better join them, I guess? I guess the reason why I'm telling you all of this is because there seems to be plenty of people who are under the false impression that this is a technology for the disabled or people with severe life-limiting diseases. The fact is, it's not. It's for perfectly healthy people like you and me. As such, Neuralink's first brain microchip, the N1, has been designed to be small, completely wireless, and invisible. To keep costs down and make the product accessible to everyday consumers, the chip will be inserted by a menacing robot that looks like this, and will have 1,000 impossibly thin threads coming out of it. These impossibly thin threads are critical as they'll be the chip's electrodes, transmitting signals from 1,000 critical areas of the brain to a computer and then sending some signals back your way. This is effectively what this chip is. It's a brain-machine interface. It's not rocket science, it's not brain surgery, even though brain surgery is involved. Neuralink's N1 microchip is a communication device, bridging the gap between your brain and a computer. And if you connect two brains to the same computer, guess what happens? The two brains are now connected. Congratulations, you've just created an internet of brains. This was actually successfully accomplished back in 2013, many years before Elon Musk founded Neuralink. In this experiment, two rats in two different countries had their brains connected together via a set of electrodes and a computer network. In each rat's cage, there were two boxes of which only one had a treat underneath. The treats were placed underneath the same box in both cages. However, only one rat could see which box the treat was under because the boxes in its cage were transparent. The other rat could not, as its boxes were opaque, and guess what happened? The seeing rat was able to send signals from its brain to the other rat, allowing it to correctly guess under which box the treat was hidden. This is despite the fact that neither rat was even aware of the other rat's existence. And if you'd like to watch a video of the actual rats from that experiment, there should be a link in the description below. And while you're down there, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe and hit the bell icon for more videos about Neuralink and everything else about the human brain. It's important to note that this has also been tried in humans. In this 2014 experiment, two people in two separate buildings were able to play a video game in collaboration. The only catch was that only one of the two men could see the screen, while the other man had the controller. Their only means of communication were EEG headsets, which were used to transmit signals from the brain of the seeing player to the brain of the player with the game controller in his hand. And despite its non-invasive nature, the procedure actually worked. The hope is that with more invasive devices like Neuralink's N1 chip, we should be able to achieve and share far more data and more complex signals. You might be wondering what the point of all of this is. Why would anyone want to connect two brains together or connect a brain to a computer device? Well, here's why. Think for a moment about all the wonderful things that we've achieved as a species. All these things would not have been remotely possible without collaborative work and our ability to build on pre-existing foundations. For example, Einstein's theory of relativity would not have been possible without Isaac Newton's earlier theory of mechanics. Of course, the two men lived more than 200 years apart and never actually met. And yet they were still able to communicate via Isaac Newton's writings. In other words, the secret behind all human progress and everything that we've ever achieved is our ability to communicate. And we've done fairly well with what we have so far. But with the advent of artificial intelligence, it might be time to step up our game and take ourselves to the next frontier. What would humanity be able to do and achieve if all 8 billion members of our species could communicate with each other backed by the input of machines and artificial technology? Is it even remotely possible? Until a few years ago, the answer would have been a resounding no. To be perfectly clear, even the world's top neuroscientists barely understand the inner workings of the human brain. There are over 86 billion neurons that communicate together to make you who you are, and a further 86 billion non-neuronal cells inside the brain that support them. According to Harvard University professor Jeff Lichtman, if everything there is to know about the human brain was a 1 mile road, then we've traveled no more than 3 inches down that road. How then can we even begin to modify something that we barely understand? Plus, it was believed that any brain-machine interface would require input from at least 1 million neurons before it would even be anywhere near useful. This would have been a colossal feat of engineering, unlikely to be achieved anytime this century or even the next one. And this is why Neuralink's big idea is actually a big idea. What if instead of 1 million neurons, you could just carefully read the signal from 1,000 carefully selected areas of the brain and then send that data off to be analyzed by artificial intelligence? These AI networks would then be able to spot the faintest patterns in that data and interpret these patterns, making something out of the limited signals the N1 microchip receives. And while it's easy to doubt the ability of AI being able to create realistic models of the behavior of 86 billion neurons from tiny sample sizes, remember that Apple's Face ID is able to reliably unlock your phone after obtaining just 2 scans of your beautiful face, and that you can provide websites with a few photos of the celebrity of your choice to create a worryingly convincing deepfake. And let's not forget that social media companies rely on AI technology to create content and deliver ads for their 3 billion users. Suddenly, 86 billion neurons doesn't sound like that much of a leap, does it? Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then you might want to check out my free Substack newsletter. I'll include a list of 13 random things that AI technology can do over there. So if you want to check that out, link in the description below, you're free to do that. And don't forget to subscribe and tell me in the comments whether you'd ever consider getting a brain microchip. If I've terrified you about the future, then I guess you should absolutely be terrified and just know that you are not alone and everyone's scared too. See you all next week.